Test Studio provides various features that enable anyone on the team to contribute to the automation effort so that everyone, no matter what kind of experience they have, should be able to craft tests and to improve the test automation and the quality of the tested product. So recording playback, of course, is one of the best Test Studio features, but for the more experienced quality assurance engineers or automation developers, we have coded steps where you can add C# or Visual Basic code and achieve very good coverage of your tests. So if something cannot be done with the recording playback, it can easily be done via coded steps. On top of that, Test Studio supports adding third-party libraries so that you can make use of other frameworks other than our own framework. For example, I can add the assemblies for the WebDriver and Selenium here. I have already added them in Test Studio, and I can start write Selenium tests directly inside Test Studio. And if I feel that I can make use of some good features of the Selenium framework, I can do that in combination with our own framework and with our own record and playback functionality inside Test Studio. So, for example, after I added those assemblies to Test Studio, I created a web test called Selenium and recorded 6 steps. Those 6 steps just log in to a simple page. Here in a coded step I have some code. So this Selenium code is doing exactly the same thing, but it shows that you can use Selenium code or you can use any other framework that is .NET based, adding the assemblies into Test Studio and start coding with that framework in combination with our own framework. I have another example of this here with my AppliTools test. So AppliTools is a platform, cloud-based platform, that enables you to compare images that you take in your application, and you can see all the differences, all the problems that you may have in the image in their cloud-based dashboard. So here I'm doing a record. I have recorded a test, and in a coded step, I'm using their assemblies and I'm using their API to send an image to their dashboard and to make the comparison and to get the result back inside Test Studio. You can see I have few lines of code here doing that, and I'm using some Test Studio framework code to get the image, to get the screenshot. So I'm using a combination of our own framework, some APIs from the .NET framework and the AppliTools ICE API to achieve a complete and good test which makes use of Test Studio's best features and some other service providers like AppliTools best features.